Evo Fennec here with another Ranked FFA replay cast, this time featuring Soren Johnson, the lead designer and founder of Mohawk Games, along with Zoltar, former community member who now works for Stardock, the publisher of Offworld, and two of the best Offworld players, Blues and Death Tacticus. This game should be a good one. What do we have on this map? We do have Expansives, Scavengers, Nomads, and Elites. I don't think we'll see any Elites, although this would be a decent spot for an Elite. It is a glass colony. There are no nukes, so that will make Scavenger play quite good, and there's a few great Scavenger founds. Thinking Scavenger first, Nomad high, Silicon low, Electronics high, Aluminum great spots for Nomad founds. So we do have a couple of good founds. If you don't get any of the Scavenger founds, like over here's a decent spot, over here's a decent spot for a Scavenger, two Nomads. That Tacticus is going to get the better Silicon, Zoltar is going to get the better water, and they're going to try and work around each other. So that's a little bit unfortunate for both of those players. Blues is going to go for an expansive right here in the middle, going to go double water and into a geotherm. That is a different opening. That is a very different opening. Soren's going to go for that one scavenger spot, going to found outside the crater next to this water, going to ship in from a very high and a low. Curious as to why he chose a very high and a low when you could choose the high and the low when you could choose the high and medium. Seems strictly better. Now claiming some aluminum now that that's there. Upgrading to HQ2, first HQ2, the scavenger. Nomads are going to buy up their electronics. Death Tacticus has electronics. Zoltar has electronics. So they're just waiting for silicon to come in and aluminum respectively. Zoltar's able to get the upgrade first. Death Tacticus having a little less silicon than aluminum. Zoltar has silicon, but Death Tacticus is able to get the upgrade relatively quickly. Blues is spent so much money on this geotherm and gooning it, and is now attempting to pay off debt, having crashed through the water price in this rather interesting strategy. Probably rotate out of these two water pumps into some steel mills. That would be probably strictly better right now, or even into some electrolysis reactors. That would at least get you the money to get to the upgrade. Blues does have plenty of glass, just trying to play with the glass. There we go, rotating into those electrolysis reactors. Soren moving into some electrolysis reactors himself, going into double aluminum. That seems like a little bit much, and then is immediately going to get EMP'd by Blues. Blues wants those reactors for himself, but was that EMP too much? An EMP cost 3k, 2k for Blues, and put him 2k behind the upgrade. So now three upgrades behind Zoltar and DT, who have to date just been going for base resources, but are now moving into electrolysis reactors themselves and picking up a geotherm for Death Tacticus, which is undefended. Blues finally getting to HQ2. Going to move into some steel mills. Probably a mistake not to have the steel mills from the beginning. Double iron. Let's check out what our Nomad friends are doing. Zoltar going into some wind turbines, chasing down this during this dust storm, although they will take 60 seconds to construct, I believe, so they'll only get the tail end of the dust storm. Extra claim auction. Soren still suffering from this freeze, still has another 45 seconds to go on this electrolysis reactor, but not getting the profits that he would have preferred, and instead a Tacticus going to be able to get the vast majority of the profits here. Zoltar able to encroach on that Tacticus territory and pick up a medium and low elemental quarry. We could check over Death Tacticus by the aluminum Tacticus appears to have gone completely out of aluminum, which makes sense. It's only $16. Breathe by blues.
A scavenger on Zoltar's HQ has power.
Soren Johnson upgrading to HQ3, a little bit behind the Nomads, but that's kind of what you'd expect after being EMP'd by an HQ1 expansive, moving into some power of his own, just as power is dying thanks to this power surplus and everybody moving into power. So that's some unfortunate timing. We'll be able to get a little bit off of this dust storm, but probably better to keep out of power and use those claims maybe for some silicon, as Soren is going into these double glass kilns, which both will provide a nice 80 a second, but is buying two silicon up off the market. Did purchase some silicon. Death Tacticus, first player with a patent lab, moving immediately into thinking machines. Let's check off-world's 31k launches. Well, that's in a large part because price is so low. Some mutinies going on. Zoltar deciding that he wants that high tile from Death Tacticus. Only one patent lab. It is gooned and hologrammed, so people may not notice that it's there. But they will in 28 seconds. Zoltar finally getting out from the freeze. What's going on with Blue? Blue's sitting over here HQ2 for quite a long time. Has 35k in the bank. Could upgrade whenever Ito chooses, but has been playing around with the short on the electronics price. Gets to the upgrade HQ3, but not before both Zoltar and Soren upgrade to HQ4. What's Zoltar going to do with that HQ4? Going into some more farms. Farms are extremely profitable. Prize at Soren. There we go. Soren's going for some farms himself and going into double silicon. Double silicon seems like a lot when you're a scavenger and you don't have many claims, and there's no claims on the market.
Let the bidding begin.
Because while the that's what's going to happen. The Nomads are going to go into the profitable glass market and they're going to quickly turn it unprofitable. So either way, you're sort of feeding the Nomads money. And Soren already spent two claims on these metal mines, and then two claims on these wind turbines over here. I mean, if you didn't have these wind turbines up here, then what you could do is later on rotate your extra claim into a solar panel here and a solar panel there. Anyway, we do have a bunch of mutinies going on. Tacticus is upset about Zoltar mutinying his stuff, so double mutinies right back, and then Zoltar decided that, you know what, if I can't have it, you can't have it, and EMP'd the whole mess.
A nomadic HQ has been upgraded.
Despite that, Zoltar, first HQ5, Soren deciding to go into a patent lab of their own. Tacticus going to slant drilling, wants to stop playing these games over the tiles here. Blue's still stuck in HQ3. That start not going, working out very well for him at all. Went into an early goon to Pleasure Dome, 265 per second, only burning through 38 debt a second. That's pretty much all of Blue's debt right there. Can upgrade to HQ4, has that upgrade, should upgrade to HQ4. Maybe try and get into some of the chems market here, as chems are going up higher or moving to more water. But Blues has plenty of water, so I'm really not sure why he's just sitting around here in HQ4 with 56k. Maybe thinking about going into some early aggression? That's what Soren thinks. Soren's going to try and defend himself while researching virtual reality. Nope, Blues decides to take the upgrade. Maybe he was worried about Death Tacticus with Death Tacticus' large amount of cash. We still have more mutinies going on between the Nomads, back and forth. I'm not even sure who owns what right now. The Tacticus has two, and then Soren has it.
I hate those filthy
Soren
mutinied
it.
HQ has been upgraded.
So Soren getting in on this action, mutiny action over here, just causing everybody lots of annoyance. Have an EMP. over on this side on Zoltar's life support, which was making pretty decent money, but right now water's making quite good money.
New building is available for auction.
So someone just sold out of that as soon as I said it. Teleportation for Soren Johnson. Let's look back at those off-world markets. They still look pretty good despite oxygen back going back up to 100. Still 32k launches, 43k launches for food despite food being 90. So definitely would expect that Tacticus to upgrade and maybe go off-world soon. Tacticus does have the picking machines and slant drilling. Soren Johnson researched virtual reality, now going for teleportation. Zoltar has water engine. Curious, Zoltar does not have, must have picked that up in a auction. Power is rising back again as people move out of power. This is going to benefit those players in power if they have enough power. Soren does not have enough power. Blues does not have enough power. Well, that's why power is back up. Nobody has enough power, so let's see a transition back into power in just a little bit. Death Tacticus finally HQ5, a mutiny on Death Tacticus. Geothermal plant by Soren Johnson. Death Tacticus does have a black market cooldown available. Could go and take that back whenever he wishes. Teleportation for Soren. Death Tacticus researching superconductor, looking to get into some solar panels, I would have to imagine, or maybe using these clips. But solar panels probably way cheaper for the Nomad. Hacking going on by Blues. Chemical hacks. Anybody in chemicals? Blues has two chemicals. Zoltar moving into some solar panels. Blues getting aggressive against Soren, freezing all of his new chemical production. Chemicals are pretty great. 66 on the board. The only thing better is a high aluminum or maybe high silicon. Anyway, Zoltar is struggling over here. D plus 2 debt. Never went into power. Now sitting on, till just now, now sitting on 217k. However, Blues getting superconductor is mass transitioning into power. 6 solar panels. Going to make a lot of money once those solar panels are online. 2.7k, although rapidly falling. Zoltar is going to buy into Death Tacticus, as Death Tacticus has no money to defend themselves. Death Tacticus does not have a lot of income. Silicon all the way down. Buying into chemicals, only has water. Needs to pay through 22k debt. Zoltar almost has enough to finish off Death Tacticus. Looks like we might have our first takeout of the game. Interrupted by a bit for some high iron. Right here in the middle of nowhere.
Congratulations.
So Blues takes that. Looking very close for Zoltar. 19k, 20. That tactic is still not making any money from power. Hasn't quite paid off through his debt, and Blues decides that a superconductor thinking machine Nomad should not live. And also, Blue wants to get the majority of Zoltar, while Zoltar's stock is cheap. So, that leaves us in a little bit of an awkward position. We have Zoltar with a sub that should be profitable in not too much longer, once the sub decides to get out of these solar panels and into something else. But Zoltar in 182k debt, and really no good way of paying that off. Only 14k in the bank. And power completely dead. Slowdown strike on the greenhouse farms. Moved into chemicals. Only long-term plan for Zoltar is a pleasure dome, which is over here. Blues, C debt, hacking, but HQ4, so not really making use of those expansive advantages. Needs to upgrade to HQ5 to get those extra claims. Could upgrade to HQ5 whenever he so chooses. Decides to do it now, losing to some more chems. Has 4 more claims to put down. Moving into some water, spreading out. Going for the iron, as iron's rather high, 108 from a high iron. That's pretty good. Hacking some steel. but also in DDET Zorin. Meanwhile, transitioning that patent lab into a sneaky off-world hologrammed as a optimization center, going to chase those 50k launches. We saw that Death Tacticus had thought about doing that earlier, but got into a fight with Zoltar. Nomads founding very close up in each other's space and not really liking it. Zoltar did pay themselves out of debt. Now Sorin is buying into Death Tacticus, has enough money, should continue to buy into Death Tacticus, and then buy up the rest of his stock. Try and make this long-term advantage of the off-world turn into a potential game winner. Also, Sorin right now sitting on some tiles that could easily be rotated due to teleportation. These $3 elemental quarries, not really using them. $83 aluminum is actually pretty good, so probably keep those. Yeah, subs moving in and off world, so Sorin will want to keep an eye on that, although it is thinking machined. Though not really easy to mutiny or freeze, but slowdown strikes are on the market and are free. Or Sorin could continue to buy into the Tacticus. Nobody else is doing that. Who's saving up for Zoltar? I would have to imagine instead of buying into the cheap stock of Death Tacticus, the Sorin buying into himself, hiding this off-world market, which looks like a optimization center optimizing. I don't think anybody else has that spotted. No, so that's a nice long-term advantage. Blues does finish buying into Death Tacticus before Zoltar can finish doing it, or Sorin can, so that's another advantage for Blues. Blues sitting on a decent cash pile right now. HQ4 in CDET, hacking well. The only problem that Blues has is no really late game plays other than this hacker array. And 50k launches, I think, beats a hacker array. That's what Sorin's betting. Sorin's going to buy straight into Blues, leaving Blues with the awkward decision of finish the original plan to take out Zoltar, also hunting for an off-world here over at Zoltar. Or does Blues refocus and try to buy through the fully defended Sorin Johnson? Once Sorin's off-world launches and actually gets enough money to finish buying into Blues, that debt tick was not kind to Blues. D plus one debt.
The black market is online.
As you remember, D plus one debt means you're not able to use black market aggression, but Blues is going to try and pay some of that off, or is fluctuating right along the edge. As Sorin increases the asset price of the company by buying into it. Blues has quite the sizable amount of cash and is 81% of the way of the buy to Zoltar, 50% of the way of the buy into Sorin. Blues doesn't know about this off-world, which is right now the only advantage that Sorin has. No optimizations, a couple patents, financial instruments, that's going to be doing good work for Sorin with everybody in D. Blues in D debt, virtual reality, cold fusion, and teleportation. Nice pleasure dome here, 306 for Sorin. It looks like Blues is going to continue the course and buy out Zoltar, then figuring with two subs, Sorin will not be able to purchase Blues. People are looking for a off-world on Blues territory, but we know Blues does not have any off-world. It's just a hacker array. It's being used as hacker array and expansive bonuses of lots of production that's propelling Blues to the spy on the Zoltar. Zoltar never able to recover from that fight with Death Tacticus, so this is going to be it. Zoltar, I expect Blues to make that purchase in just a minute. Zoltar paying off debt, just trying to make things as annoying for Blues as possible, which of course means that Sorin has 45% of the buy on to Blues, and Blues is in D plus a 3 debt right now, which means Blues' share price is going to continue to decrease. Although it will receive a sizable bump if Blues is ever able to make the buy. These frozen farms earning a lot of debt for Blues right now, plus 326 per second. Meanwhile, Soren just continuing to launch offloads, making 741 per second off of this offload market, or 45k profit per launch every 65 seconds. There we go, there is the buy. So it is a race between Soren Johnson and Blues. Soren is almost 50% of the way of the buy, so he needs to come up with another $300,000. Could get half of that, just under half of that, by selling out of his own shares before Blues does, but you don't want to do that until you're getting close to the buy, although Blues is struggling in debt right now. Trying to pay off as much debt as possible. Perhaps, I'm not sure what that stock price was doing, but Blues is getting lots of money from these subs, Debt Tacticus, two offload markets on, chasing those same launches. Soren is going to sell out of the stock right now, trying to end it here and now before Blues' advantage of the subs can propel him to the end. 81% of the buy, 86% of the buy, 84% of the buy. Blues is going to buy right back into Soren. Soren needs to sell out of this one last share. It needs to, this offload market and finish launching. That will be another 52k in the bank. 182% of the way there. It looks like Soren is going to have this. So let's turn this on fast. Just fast forward a little bit to the what looks like inevitable conclusion, especially with this debt tick back into D plus 196% the way, 94. It's getting close. Soren's not launching another offload launch. That might be a mistake. How is Soren going to get 4% of the way there? Soren needs 800 magic number, which is rapidly climbing as Blues is paying off debt. Soren going back into that off world. 60 seconds should be enough for Soren to win the game. Blues is nowhere near the cash needed to make the buy. We do have our mod, tournament mod here, glitching out a little bit as we're on fast forward. But it looks like Soren will clean this up, so we'll fast forward to Blazing. Once this launch comes up, that should be the next 6% to finish the deal. Blues freezing everything but the tile that matters the most, the offworld market. And in 9 seconds, Soren will be able to finish the game. There goes the offworld, there's the buy button. Soren wins it. Well played game by Soren, and nice. Not necessarily come from behind victory, but it definitely was not a lead turned into victory, but that's one of the beauties of the free-for-all format. We can see this was cast in during tournament mod, and tournament mod does give out ranks, tiebreakers between those who are in last. So we can scroll up here and see here that Blues actually made more money than Soren overall. Made more money during when buying out Zoltar, and had made more money when Zoltar bought out Death Tacticus, but wasn't able to recoup that invested money from Zoltar in time to beat Soren. And a part of that probably because of Blue's unique starting strategy of going double water pump and using up a lot of steel into this geotherm. We can take a look at the charts and graphs really quick. We see Soren made a lot of their money off of that offworld market, 519k based on the Soren made 1.1k, so that's just a little bit over half of it off of this one, under half of it, just off of this one building. See, the Blues made a decent money off playing around with hacks and selling chems, steel, iron. Not as many hex as I had thought going into it. Only one on electronics. A shortage. That was a surplus. And then four shortages, two on steel and one on iron. So that's probably where Blues lost the game. No optimizations from any players. No. Blues not going into patents, but Soren and Tacticus making good use of the patents. And then Soren the only one in an off-world market. I hope you enjoyed this replay cast. Always fun to cast the game with the lead designer of Offworld Trading Company, Soren Johnson, versus some of the best and top players. So if you enjoyed it, hit that like button, subscribe, or leave a message in the comments. Philothanic, signing out.